I'm Dean Sotereanos. I am director of hand surgery at UPMC Passavant. I was formerly director at UPMC Presby and then went to Allegheny General for a period of time, and now I'm back at UPMC. I specialize in hand, elbow, and shoulder surgery, but today we're going to focus on surgery of the carpal tunnel and cubital tunnel, two very common conditions. Carpal tunnel syndrome is a condition in the hand which affects a nerve called the median nerve. When someone has carpal tunnel syndrome, they present with wrist pain and numbness in the thumb, index, and long finger. The condition can keep people awake at night, can be bothersome during activities of daily living, and be problematic with other activities as well. Cubital tunnel is a condition at the elbow involving the nerve called the ulnar nerve. That's a condition that will lead to numbness in the ring and the small fingers, as well as some weakness with hand function. People develop cubital and carpal tunnel syndrome for a variety of reasons, one of which may be repetitive use, which is very commonly heard on the media and the newspapers. Other conditions can be traumatic. If someone would take a blow to the elbow or the wrist, it can lead to carpal or cubital tunnel. And sometimes it's even with activities such as typing or in the construction field, jackhammering, cutting hair, etc. Very common causes of those conditions. The treatment for cubital tunnel can be varied. The treatment which I prefer is a minimally invasive treatment that simply involves unroofing the sheath or the ligament that sits over the nerve. With this simple procedure, people can experience marked pain relief and marked relief of their numbness. It depends on the chronicity of the condition, how long someone's had it, and other factors as well that determine outcome. In regards to carpal tunnel syndrome, the treatment also involves release of a ligament that compresses the nerve. It is probably the most common procedure performed in the world, and it's common because it works well. The procedures are both common procedures because they work. People undergo the operation, and sometimes the same night as the surgery, there's symptomatic relief, especially with carpal tunnel. With cubital tunnel, it can also occur very rapidly, but generally it takes a bit longer. Length of recovery for a carpal tunnel release generally is approximately 2 to 6 weeks. In regards to the cubital tunnel, it's a little longer, 1 to 2 months. Early intervention often involves steroid injections, splinting, and other non-operative modalities. Surgery will only be at the end stage of treatment when we know that everything else has failed. In regards to both conditions, it is important to get treatment. If one does not get treatment for cubital tunnel at the elbow, they can often notice marked weakness in the hand and the inability to grasp or grip. This would be a chronic stage condition. In regards to the carpal tunnel, with lack of sensation in the thumb, index, and long finger, they won't be able to discriminate whether they're touching a quarter or a penny if they put their hand in their pocket. So it is important to be treated appropriately and not too late. Some simple methods of treatment for carpal tunnel would be to wear a splint at night. That certainly could provide a lot of benefit and better sleep for you. In regards to the elbow, the advice I'll give you is to try to keep the elbow straight and not flexed. The ulnar nerve wasn't designed by God the right way. It should not be stretching around a bone in your elbow. It's the only nerve that does that. There's really no reason to live with these conditions if they can be treated easily and oftentimes conservatively. Come in and see us, and we'll do the right thing for you. My favorite thing as a physician is to see happy patients after treatment.